everybody, and welcome to Armored Warfare. And today I got three games for you guys. So make yourself comfortable because we're going to have a lot of fun. Anyway, first game, the M1A1 Abrams, and it's driven by me, myself. So our three games are from myself, and well, in different setups. Actually, three different maps, and of course, well, of course, PvP. Reactor, I don't know what to think. It is a limited map, in my opinion, and especially if you play the skirmish mode, you cannot do much more than go flank right, left, or even go, you know, through the middle. That's it. Actually, the MBT-70 just took one on the chin for 530 hit points, so that's a good start. And I must say, I am very charmed by the Abrams, and I've always been by the Abrams. There is the Merkava, and he shaves 422 of my health. And oops, I'm in a pickle here because the BMD-2 has my side, the Merkava is on the other side, and I still don't understand why the Merkava didn't follow through. I was lucky, I guess. He didn't. He was paying attention to someone else. I get help from the T-80, but the T-80 is overcommitting, and I focus myself on the MBT-70 to help out the T-80. And well, should not be such a problem. The M1 Abrams will penetrate the MBT-70 with ease if you know where to shoot, of course. And the lower plate, simply aim there, then it's guaranteed that you will penetrate. And I got hit for the second time for 449, so I have to go back, I have to pull back, I have to save my hit points. And we see here the MBT-70 comes after me, and I take the MBT-70 out with one shot, 496 damage, and kaboom, that was kill number one. Now I'm going after the Merkava, and our friendly T-80, well, didn't make it. Simply, he overcommitted, and he should not have gone that far, should have stayed with me. Anyway, I'm going after the Merkava, and the Merkava is going to do something very, very funny, because he doesn't focus on me. I'm taking his hit points, but he is focusing on the friendly BMD-4. Well, I'm fine with it. I'm simply keep knocking on his door and keep taking off his hit points. So why he just focuses on the BMD, that's probably the tunnel vision that I also suffer from sometimes, that I simply don't focus enough. And in the end, it's too late, and kaboom, kill number two for me. And that was the end of the game. It was a skirmish of 3v3, and that's why I put up more games. Anyway, I did 5,108 damage. I destroyed two enemies, highest reputation under winning team, and I got the Master Gunner, and I got some pretty nice shine, the Iron Dragon, I think, and something else, another nice medal. Well, here is, you see the overview, the damage that I did. Well, I took literally all of the Merkava's hit points, so 1605 damage done on the MBT-70, and here is the team lineup. Well, two of the three, and the BMD-4 also made a kill. So, decent game, fast, but okay. So, you will see here also I did almost 700,000 credits. I was very pleased with that. And so let's look now at the next game. And the next game is going to be, yes, the Merkava on chemical plant. And this is a little bit of a standoff. I mean, I chose this position because I know it can be very beneficial for you between the trains. But the thing is, everyone knows that this is a favorite spot, so you will be targeted, so you have to be very careful. Don't overcommit, stay as long as possible hidden. And I make here a bad mistake here, focusing to the straight in front of me, but overseeing the BMD-3 on my right flank, who is there exposed but I can get a shot in, and I took him for 437. So, but still, I lost 652. So the trade-off is not that good. So I have to be careful not to lose more hit points and keep my right flank monitored, because the enemy is simply going over the right flank, and that's the strategy. But there are some leftovers here, and of course those are usually or TDs, AAVs. But you know, keep your composure, and that's something I'm telling myself constantly while I'm playing, keeping my composure during gameplay. And that's not always easy, I can tell you honestly. I mean, you see a opportunity, a chance, and you want to go after it, but you have to realize that always going after the easy target can also you have to pay probably a very high price, because you get killed. So better not overcommit. Take your shot, take your damage shot, you know, take it, and don't think like I'm going after him like a fool idiot. I mean, don't do that. Don't do that. Anyway, just take your time. And especially when you have no support, and in my case, I have, I'm here quite alone. So there is no way I can simply start pushing now and hoping that someone will come with me. And we all know how that works. Working together is not the strongest, strongest feature in this game amongst team members. And, anyway, there is the WZ-1224. Still a very decent tank. It got bumped up to tier 6. I don't know if that's the right choice, but it was of course very powerful. There is the LAV. I have to be careful. The BMD-2M of the Merkava 2D is now shooting at me from a long range. There he is. And I will make sure. So I'm focusing on him. I don't know this move, why he did that. He know he would expose his side. But there is more. More tanks over there that will have to cross or expose. So I do a blind shot actually through the smoke, and I hit the WZ-1224 once more, and he's now on very low health, 184 hit points left. So he just needs one another tap on the head, and then he is simply signed off. As someone was asking me, Freddy, kaboom, kill number, let's make first kill actually, kill number one. There's the BMD 2, and did quite, didn't do any damage, thank God for that, because I was frontally, I had my armor well angled. There is the, yes, the WZ-1224, I got him finally, I took all of his hit points. So now I'm going after those two here, and indeed a BMD-2, and friendly takes him out. And here is the LAV, and I'm still reloading, and no, and kaboom, the friendly takes him out, and that's another win, and a quite decent game. Not spectacular, but you know, still did 5016 damage. I spotted 4, I destroyed 2 enemies. Highest reputation on the winning team, Master Gunner. So I was quite pleased with myself about this game, and you can see a little bit what I did. I shaved off 1311 from the WZ, and in total 1300 and a little bit from the LAV-600. Actually did much more to the WZ, because there was more damage written underneath. But anyway, I did 3,427 base reputation. That is very decent. I had 651 spotting damage. So, all in all, I had quite a reasonable game in my Merkava. I love the Merkava. I love the ready rack on the Merkava, because it gives you gives potential. And it has quite a good penetration rate, so I'm quite happy. So that means this is the last game, and this one is in my, well, my most loved, I think, most favorite tank, the T-ATU, and I think a lot of you love the T-ATU, and mostly also because he has this little trollish armor and a little bit of, you know, he's fast. And you can bounce on the THU. Trust me, it's you have to keep moving. You have to keep moving. And yesterday evening we discussed this also on stream, that this spot is somehow pre-targeted. I mean, people are shooting randomly and blindly in this on this target, on this spot. And I got even hit, and even my friend Alex also got hit, I think twice. So this spot, keep in mind, people that play a lot, because you play a lot this map, this location is pre-targeted. Now I know that the enemy has, of course, one main battle, two main battle tanks, and of course the two AAVs and the Stingray. Now the Stingray is something you have to be careful and look out for. I don't foresee much problems with the Chieftain, but the Chieftain 900 could give me some problems. So I am approaching it very, very cautious, because I don't want to be surprised. And I got, the team is really working perfectly. They are spotting, they are going after. So I've got a lot of a view of the battlefield entirely, and so that is such an advantage. And the team stayed compact, stayed together, and that's of course also good, but in this case predictable, very predictable. Anyway, there is the Chieftain 900, and I set him on fire. Oh, that's a nice start. So that's well over like 1400 damage done. I was still burning, now it's off. So the total 1700. 1700 something. It's like 60 almost. Anyway, that's a good beginning. And we're already at 2900 damage done. And I decide, you know, I'm not going to chase them. I'm simply going to wait here because they're going to expose themselves. There's the Chieftain 900. And I have to expect any moment a tap on the head back from him. Oh, tick, tap. I took him out. That's one kill. That shot was already, well, it was already in. 540 that he took. So I was a little bit behind, guys. Anyway, tonight and afternoon I'm going to stream again tonight, for sure. And maybe tonight, just a short amount of time, we're gonna play Armored Warfare, because I'm doing almost every day Armored Warfare, and also want to play something else for a change. Anyway, still looking for the Stingray and the BMD-2, but I don't have to look far, because this is quite a favorite spot. There is one enemy, and there is the Kaboom! That was a beautiful kill, actually. That was a beautiful kill. And it was not my kill, because he killed himself. I thought I had to kill. Well, the Springfire cannot fire because the keyboard is not working. I learned the trick now. Use your control key, control, and then with your mouse select your things what you need to select on your machine. Anyway, he doesn't put up much of a fight, the Stingray 2. I a little bit overextend, but he bounces, it's trollish. So, and that's exactly, well, he hit me anyway for 486, but I take him out. There is the Chieftain, still alive, only 354 hit points left. And I should not have a problem with him, because I'm a tier 7, and that's of course a tier 5. And of course I'm also top tier, and it's a tier 7 game, so you know, I have to do what is expected of me, and that's carry and win for my team. Anyway, there he is, Kaboom, and that was kill number 3 for me. So I did actually quite good, right? 4 versus 4 and killing 3 of the 4 enemies. Kill. That shot was already, well, it was already in, 540 that he took. So, I was a little bit behind, guys. Anyway, tonight and afternoon I'm going to stream. Again, tonight, for sure. And maybe tonight, just a short amount of time, we're going to play Armored Warfare. Because I'm doing almost every day Armored Warfare. and also want to play something else for a change. Anyway, still looking for the Stingray and the BMD 2, but I don't have to look far, because this is quite a favorite spot. There is one enemy, and there is the kaboom. That was a beautiful kill, actually. That was a beautiful kill. And it was not my kill, because he killed himself. I thought I had to kill. Well, the Springfire cannot fire because the keyboard is not working. I learned the trick now. Use your control key, control, and then with your mouse select your things what you need to select on your machine. Anyway, he doesn't put up much of a fight, the Stingray 2. I a little bit overextend, but he bounces, it's trolleys. So, and that's exactly. Well, he hit me anyway for 486. But I take him out. There is the Chieftain. Still alive. Only 354 hit points left. And I should not have a problem with him. Because I'm a tier 7. And that's of course a tier 5. And of course I'm also top tier. And it's a tier 7 game. So, you know, I have to do what is expected of me. And that's carry and win for my team. Anyway. There he is. Kaboom. And that was kill number 3 for me. So I did actually quite good, right? 4 versus 4 and killing 3 of the 4 enemies. That's actually very good, in my opinion. Anyway, let's check out the stats and let's see how I did. I did 5,063 damage. I didn't spot, that's true. And I destroyed 3 enemies. Highest reputation earned on the winning team. Master Gunner, Iron Dragon. And another medal. I didn't see which.